What are the best? Worst chest exercises for muscle growth? Well, for a chest movement to rank highly, it needs to tick three boxes. One, a big stretch with high tension. If it doesn't offer high tension in a deep stretch, I'm putting it in F tier, no exceptions. Two, it needs to feel good. It shouldn't cause pain, and it should have a smooth resistance profile. Giving a good pump and a nice mind-muscle connection would be nice too. Three, it needs to have a simple progression. If you can't progressively overload by adding weight or reps, that's not good. And after ranking 20 of the most popular movements from S for super to F for fail, at the end, I'll crown one exercise as the best of the chest, raising it to S tier plus, and one as the most inept for the pecs, sending it to F tier hell. All right, let's get the worst out of the way. The hex press. I'm not a big fan of—
Hello, everybody.
These. First, you never get a big stretch in your pecs because your arms never stretch out. They stay tucked in the whole time. And they don't offer maximum tension because your triceps will take over. There's no evidence that these target the inner pecs. In fact, I think they'd probably be worse for the inner pecs than a standard dumbbell press since the inner pec fibers aren't getting as stretched here. The hex press is going in F tier. The plate press is basically a hex press that feels even more awkward with even less overload potential, so it's also going in F tier. The dumbbell pullover is a tricky one. Biomechanics tells us that the pecs do help perform this movement alongside the lats and triceps. And when you look at the activation data, the pecs do activate on pullovers. The problem is, I simply don't feel my pecs when I do this movement whatsoever, and more or less every client I've ever worked with says the same. And I don't see many top bodybuilders putting these on their chest day. So despite some theoretical merit, I think pullovers—
React to this.
Let me see, Dodo.
It appears that officials in Israel are really helping the International Criminal Court build its case against Israeli officials for blocking humanitarian aid into the Gaza Strip, because there are some pretty big stories in the news today regarding how there's evidence of authorities from Israel colluding with settlers to essentially share details about the location of humanitarian aid convoys so the settlers can attack them. There's also evidence indicating that—
So how do we get from the police are corrupt to it's Netanyahu's fault and he's telling them to do this? How in the fuck does this help the argument that Netanyahu is trying to starve Gaza? Like, it's just so fucking retarded. Do you have evidence that Netanyahu is telling the police to tip people off to attack aid convoys? It's just fucking retarded. On top of that, look at the daily data for the amount of aid trucks going into Gaza. Just because a few fucking assholes fuck with some of these aid trucks doesn't mean it makes a significant difference.
Oh, the fucking setters crap again.
Yeah, colonizer, all this fucking bullshit. Thanks for the donation, Dodo.
Israeli officials do not want authorities to essentially protect the humanitarian aid convoys as they're attempting to get to Gaza. And we've got some pretty brutal announcements by the United Nations about how they are halting the distribution of food within Gaza. So why don't we start off with an insane story reported by The Guardian. In an exclusive report, The Guardian found that members of the Israeli security forces, including police and members of the IDF, are tipping off settlers about the location of aid convoys so settlers can basically attack them. And we have seen footage of settlers attacking aid trucks and aid convoys.
This idea doesn't really sound all that likely to me, because 22,000 trucks have entered Gaza so far. 22,000. How in the fuck would people not just figure out where these aid trucks are on their own? Like, there's many, 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 and they also have to go through security checkpoints. So, I mean, it's plausible, but like the likelihood of this actually being true just, I don't know, it doesn't pass the sniff test.
Boys, there was a recent example out of the West Bank. You're watching a video of humanitarian aid convoys that had been set on fire by Israeli settlers. And so the Guardian was able to review internal internet chat groups, as well as accounts from witnesses and human rights activists. And they found that there is absolutely evidence of collusion here. So let's go to some of the graphics, including this statement from Rachel Tautu, who is a spokesperson for the Israeli group known as Tzav 9. She said that the group had been blocking trucks as they made their way through Israel since January.
So, what does this have to do with the Israeli government? Nothing. Gray Knight donated $2. Who do you think has the highest and lowest IQ on this post? Well, probably obvious who the bottom would be. Probably Sneeko, then Mia Khalifa, then what's her name, and then probably this bitch. Be my guess. Thanks for the donation, Gray Knight.
January, on the grounds that the aid they carried was hijacked by Hamas once it reached Gaza. Now, this is a talking point that is repeated by the United States, although there's been no
By the way, there's evidence of this.
Evidence to prove that that's the case. We have seen endless videos of Palestinians desperately trying to get humanitarian aid from these convoys. That kind of footage exists. There's no indication that Hamas comes in, steals the aid, and then tries to sell it to Palestinians. Now, Rachel Tautu also says that
U.S. says Hamas briefly seized first aid shipment that entered Gaza via reopened crossing. State Department says UN in the process has...
That was Selena Gomez. You're referring to VGO Selna. Why?
What do you mean? Why did I rank her first? Well, Greta Thunberg is like a fucking retarded pro-Palestinian. I haven't seen Selena Gomez's... shit, but about Palestine, but you know.
Are you cold? New Frankievitz to watch.
I'm not cold, but I am tired as fuck. Did not get nearly enough sleep. But I'll check on Frank in just a minute. Thanks for the donation, James. Yeah, so State Department says UN in the process or has now recovered the humanitarian assistance stolen by terror group. The first widespread case of diversion acknowledged by US. Hamas managed to seize a major shipment of humanitarian aid that was delivered to Gaza from Jordan earlier this week. US State Department spokesperson Matthew Miller said Thursday. After the supplies were first to be shipped to the enclave through a newly reopened Israeli border crossing. Secretary of State Antony Blinken viewed the aid on Tuesday just before it departed from the headquarters of the Jordan Hashemite Charity Organization in Amman, bound for the renovated crossing into the Gaza Strip at Erez, which was largely destroyed by Hamas during its October 7th terrorist onslaught that sparked the ongoing war. So shipment was unloaded by the Jordanian military inside the strip before being picked up by a humanitarian implementer for the distribution inside Gaza, and that aid was intercepted and diverted by Hamas on the ground in Gaza. The UN is either in the process or has by now recovered that aid, but it was an unacceptable act by Hamas to divert this aid to begin with, he said during a press briefing. Miller added that UNRWA, the United States National Agency for Palestinian Refugees, would likely issue a statement soon condemning the incident, indicating it was the organization from which Hamas stole the aid. So the UN, the US State Department, and UNRWA have all acknowledged that Hamas is stealing aid. And then they fucking claim, where's the evidence that Hamas is stealing aid?
Why did you have trouble sleeping?
I don't really know. I've had trouble sleeping for the last, week. It was really fucking bad yesterday, dude. I didn't sleep for, almost 24 hours. And I only just got about 4 or 5 hours of sleep. It was really bad. I did the stream, couldn't sleep. I did a workout, still couldn't sleep. And then I ended up going out and buying a battery for the bike, getting some donuts, coming back home, still couldn't fucking sleep, and I only got to sleep 4 or 5 hours ago. Thanks for the donation, though, James. Grand Dam, let me see.
All right, earlier today...
Yeah, I've already seen this. We reacted to it yesterday. Thanks for the donation, Grand Dam.
When a policeman or soldier's mission is supposed to protect Israelis and instead he is sent to protect humanitarian aid convoys, knowing it will end up in the hands of Hamas, we cannot blame them or civilians who notice the trucks passing by their towns for providing intel to groups trying to block that aid. Yes, some of our intel comes from individual members of Israeli forces, she said. And by the way, she also continues to say that Israel has been delivering the humanitarian aid without expecting anything in return. Okay, I'm gonna pause right there. What kind of statement is that? What kind of statement is that? What do you want powerless Palestinian civilians in Gaza to give you in return for life?
Don't shoot rockets at us. Maybe don't commit terror attacks and blow up buses. I don't know. Maybe that's what they expect in return.
Life-saving humanitarian aid that has been effectively blocked by Israel. And now we're hearing word that you have security forces colluding with settlers in order to attack those aid convoys as they attempt to enter the Gaza Strip. Anyway, let me read the rest of it to you. And 80% of the population agrees with our stance. That's actually true, unfortunately. She continues, Hamas is reselling this aid to civilians, which is meant to be distributed for free. We will continue to block this humanitarian aid until they can prove that it is reaching the civilians. I mean, I think maybe there needs to be some evidence that Hamas is intercepting this humanitarian aid and that it's not.
The US State Department, the UN, and UNRWA have all acknowledged that Hamas is stealing the aid coming into Gaza. So you're fucking lying or you're stupid and you don't know any better.
Not getting to Palestinians. The main reason why the aid's not getting to Palestinians is because of Israel blocking the aid. And then they'll turn around, have some of their spoke.
Right. They're blocking the aid, but you can see well over 100 aid trucks coming into Gaza every single day. Sure.
People go on national television and gaslight the American people into thinking that no, they're totally allowing aid to enter the Gaza Strip with no problems whatsoever. Obviously, that's not the case. Now, Ben-Gvir also wants authorities who are doing their jobs in protecting the aid trucks to essentially stop doing that. I'll give you the details on that element of the story in just a moment. But Cenk, really curious to hear what you think so far.
I think anyone stopping humanitarian aid from reaching starving human beings is disgusting. I think they're the worst people on earth.
Oh yes, they're the worst people on earth. But Hamas, who fucking murdered innocent people, raped women, set people on fire, kidnapped people, they're just a little bit better. Uh-huh.
Monstrous.
The outrage is over this.
Okay, they're just Young Turks is just fucking stupid. Unfortunately, it appears that Frank has not made any new content, James. So we won't be watching any more Frank Tufano tonight.
Are a much better lat exercise than a pec exercise, and for that reason, I'm gonna put them in D tier. All right, let's look at some better exercises. The bench press. My ranking might surprise you here. It offers high tension on the pecs as long as you bring the bar all the way down to your chest. It's very easy to overload, and you can always add some weight over time as you get stronger. It feels good to me, although many people do complain that the bench press makes their shoulders feel a little cranky. I suspect that's because they're trying to lift more weight than they should be lifting, but I still hear the issue commonly enough that I do count it as a slight negative. So if it were just me, I think I'd probably put the bench press in S tier. I credit most of my own pec development to this exercise. However, it is true that the barbell won't allow the pecs to get in quite as deep of a stretch as dumbbells do, since it'll come up solid against your rib cage, and based on my coaching experience, not everyone gets as much pec activation out of the bench press as I do. So for that reason, I'm gonna hesitantly drop it back to A tier. The incline bench press has all the same upsides as the flat bench press, except it slightly emphasizes the upper pecs. Now, a lot of people think this means it isn't as good for the mid and lower pecs as the flat bench. However, a recent study found that the incline bench press caused the same lower and mid.
Shout out, I need $2. Let me see. Okay, I don't know why you wouldn't have fucking warned me, jackass. Graph content, viewer discretion advised. Three boys' bodies being discovered together, all without organs. Obviously, the organs were harvested, but as usual, the authorities are never able to catch the criminals in the harmonious and happy socialist country. So is China. Well, that's China for you. In China, CCP oppression reaches a new low with the use of human containment tubes on Uyghur children. These devices, touted as legitimate medical devices, are instruments of torture. I have no idea what that is. That's really weird. I can't tell if this is just a bullshit propaganda post or if this is for some actual medical reason. I don't know what that is. Chinese Communist Party spy threatening and intimidating me under my post on Twitter. Switching from ROC to PRC, what a dumb move. Those that turn against their own race deserve the worst that's coming. Chinese could give mercy to the enemy, but to a person that betrayed their own race, there will be no mercy given for that person. Okay. China recruiting spies in the form of college kids. Oh boy. Of course. Dude, college kids are so fucking stupid. Like, they're absolutely worthless retards. Ugh. Thanks for the donation, Dodo.
Mid-pec growth as the flat bench did, plus better upper pec growth. So it's very close to S tier, but I think I'm gonna leave it in A tier as well. The decline bench press doesn't have any long-term research comparing pec growth like the incline and flat bench. However, biomechanics tells us that a decline angle should target the mid and lower pecs a bit more. However, it has two minor downsides. For one, in my experience, more people struggle with getting their upper pecs to grow than their mid to lower pecs, so if you're trying to shift the bias, I would shift it toward the upper pecs for most people. Second, the decline bench does have slightly less range of motion than.
That was a based comment about one who turns against their own race.
Not really, but thanks for the donation, Dodo.
And both the flat and the incline press. So, out of the three angle options, I would say it's my least favorite. I know some people swear by it, and it clearly is an effective chest builder. It's very close to being in A tier, but I'm gonna put it in B tier. All right, the flat dumbbell press. This offers a deeper stretch on the pecs than the barbell because the dumbbells can move freely past the rib cage. They feel great, you should get a great chest pump on these, and because people are less likely to let their ego take over on this exercise.
You can't have the dumbbells come past your rib cage if you're actually using a heavy amount of weight. Like, you're not doing that with 100-pound dumbbells.
Exercise, it's less common for people to have shoulder issues. As a beginner and intermediate level lifter, you should be able to progressively overload this movement just fine by either adding reps or increasing the weight of the dumbbells. However, once you get decently strong, you may max out the dumbbell rack at your gym, which usually stops at 100 pounds. Also, once you get that strong, the dumbbells get so big and bulky that they can be quite awkward to handle. So while the flat dumbbell press is just about an S tier, it's getting knocked down to A tier for those potential overloading issues in more advanced lifters. The incline dumbbell press is also going in A tier, since it's the same basic movement with the same upsides and downside, except again, it has slightly more emphasis on the upper pecs. And I'm putting the decline dumbbell press in B tier, since I do find it awkward to set up. You'll probably need someone to hand you the dumbbells, and again, lower pecs rarely need any extra emphasis. Okay, the machine chest press. A good chest press machine will give a nice deep stretch on the pecs and provide high tension throughout the range of motion. Unlike barbells and dumbbells, you're more locked in, which should help increase the mind-muscle connection with your pecs and give a massive pump. Machines are very easy to overload. You can always add some weight or a rep from week to week, and they have the advantage of being a little safer to push to failure than free weights. Assuming you have a good chest press machine that ticks all those boxes, I really can't think of a downside from a muscle building standpoint. And so the machine chest press.
Dodo, do I tell you, have you seen this game? Are you going to play it? What do you think? Oh, Alone in the Dark? Doesn't look that great, so I'm not going to bother. Thanks for the donation, Dodo.
S is our first exercise getting awarded to S tier. All right, dips. Let's see. Massive stretch on the pecs, possibly the best compound exercise I'm aware of.
Did you see this? It's a long video.
Let me see, Grandam. Professor defends dead Iranian President Rossi. Well, that sounds retarded. Let's watch it.
The president of Iran is dead. Ibrahim Raisi was killed in a helicopter crash yesterday, along with the country's foreign minister and several others. Raisi was a hardline cleric who was close to Iran's supreme leader. Many believed he was even his likely successor. Raisi was also part of the so-called Death Commission, which ordered the extrajudicial executions of thousands of political prisoners in 1988. His current Iranian regime stands accused of sowing chaos in the Middle East through its Triple H proxies, Hezbollah, the Houthis, and Hamas. So is the Middle East and the world a safer place today? And in significant developments elsewhere, could Israel's Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu face arrest for war crimes after major announcements from the International Criminal Court? We'll debate that in a moment. But first, with a view from Iran, Professor Mohammed Mirandi from the University of Tehran. Professor, thank you for coming back on Uncensored. First of all, your reaction to the death of the president yesterday.
Obviously, everyone that I know is in mourning. He was a very popular figure. He was a very humble person, very different from the description that you gave. He worked very hard for the deprived, the working class, the disenfranchised.
This guy was in favor of murdering women who refused to wear a hijab. So, yeah, this dude's a fucking psycho.
He traveled from city to city, from town to town. He was constantly visiting the different provinces. And that's why he was so popular among, especially, as I said, the more disenfranchised and middle-class, lower-middle-class Iranians.
I mean, you painted what many would view as a ridiculous picture of a man dubbed the Butcher of Tehran, somebody whose death was greeted by many women posting images of themselves celebrating his death because of the appalling suppression that he...
And the Nazis also mourned Hitler. What the point?
Yeah, I know. This dude seems like a fucking whack job right off the bat. Thanks for the donation, Dodo.
Put them under. And we know that he was responsible for the deaths of many thousands of political prisoners. So I don't quite categorize him as the person that you're trying to describe to us.
Well, obviously, what you're saying is inaccurate, to say the least. I would say the butchers are in London, in Washington, the people who destroyed Iraq, Afghanistan, Yemen during the disgraceful genocide there, the dirty war in Syria, the destruction of Libya, the sanctions on Venezuela and Cuba. I think that the real monsters are actually much more closer to home. He was a part of the judiciary, and those people that you were saying were executed were, he wasn't executing people. He was in the judiciary at the time, and the people who you're alluding to, and the numbers are far less than what you claim, they're actually, this is something that your government should be ashamed of. These are people who fought against Iran. They fought for Saddam Hussein as foot soldiers. They betrayed the country. They carried out bomb attacks in this country, killing up to 17,000 people, including president, a prime minister, and a head of judiciary. A bomb explosion near my house when I was a school student.
This is all a lie. So Iran executes political dissenters. So I don't know how many dozens of women have been rounded up with the hijab protests and have been fucking killed. Anybody who's a political dissenter, who's criticized the ruling class in Iran, they've all been killed. They've even killed some of their athletes. Some of their athletes who have been outspoken against the Iranian regime, they fucking murdered. They also order the murder of U.S. citizens abroad. There are Iranian death squads that come to the U.S. to fucking murder political dissenters, even in the U.S. Like, this guy's just a whack job.
Getting ready to go to school. It killed 9 to 11 people, including an Armenian family of four. These are the people who you're saying they were murdered by Iranians. No, in Iran, no one has any sympathy for the MEK terrorist organization, which today has a major base in Albania, and it has offices across Europe and North America. So it is your government that's supporting terrorism. It is your government and your governments that are really the brutal regimes that the...
You know, Professor, you came on and said...
Okay, this is fucking retarded. Like, where does he think, like, ISIS, Hezbollah, Hamas, where are they getting their money and weapons from, jackass?
You came on and spun this sort of stuff last time with the same smirk that you're doing it with this time. And the reason I find the smirk so irksome is because everybody actually outside of your office right now is looking at this thinking, is this guy for real? Given that Iran's tentacles in terms of terrorism are very transparently flowing through the three H's, as I described them, Hezbollah, Houthis, Hamas. We know that your country, Iran, through its regime, has been responsible for horrendous terrorism now for a very long time. Why do you expect people watching these interviews when you do them to just calmly believe you when you say that all the bad guys are everybody else and the downtrodden, oppressed, much misunderstood?
What do you think of the supposed growth of religion? While not good, do you think the issue overstated? Because it seems to be mostly because of births, and not adults converting slash actually believing.
Every single religion is in decline. So when you look at it from a percentage of the population who are believers, every single religion is in decline. When you look at just growth in sheer numbers, there are religions that are growing, but again, that's purely because they're just getting born into the religion. So especially with Islam, people just force it on their kids and then they become Muslim, because they're just forced to from a young age. But religion is dying out. I would say it is a problem, especially if we want to maintain, you know, secular values. But yeah, religion's just dying out. Thanks for the donation, Goomba. Dodo donated $2. Let me see.
What's happening in Russia is basically a Republican wet dream. They have banned the international LGBT movement. They're restricting abortion. Vladimir Putin invokes a lot of what Republicans call wokeness. It just seems that MAGA heads, they're much more comfortable with that authoritarian persona, especially when the guy is white, male, Christian.
Shirtless, hairless.
Makes sense. Press secretary claims Trump's ad calling for unified Reich was posted by random unknown staffer. Here's Trump saying that he and his top right-hand man, Don Scavio, have access to post on that only he and his top right-hand man, Dan Scavino, have access to post on his social media accounts.
You know, it started off with Dan Scavino. I said, Dan, how do you work this thing? And I started dictating. I began by dictating to Dan and a couple of other people that we had, but they weren't Dan. And I'd dictate something. And all of a sudden, people started following. And then on occasion, like about once every 3 years, Dan wouldn't be around because he was always there. I couldn't get rid of this guy. I call him the most powerful man in politics because he's the only one that has my number. He could say, I don't like you, voters. I don't like you at all. I'm fed up with you. I can't stand you. And that's the end of my political career. Dan's the only one that can do that. Where are you, Dan? Most powerful man in politics, I say. The most powerful. I mean, although I give it to you, I trust you implicitly, I give it to you. But Dan could say something horrible. He could say something very sexually oriented. And that, you know, would end it, okay? That would end it. You know, it started off with Dan.
Yeah, I'm not so sure what to believe. What is the fucking deal with right-wing Republicans? Like, posting Nazi propaganda, like, what was his fucking name? DeSantis? He had the Nazi fucking thing in his campaign ad?
Under fire for a video he posted on social media that used language from Nazi Germany. The latest in a series of anti-Semitic and authoritarian statements from Trump and his campaign. Rachel Scott has the story. Good morning, Rachel.
George, good morning. Of course, it is normal for presidential candidates to share videos with their vision for the country. It is not normal for those videos to include references to Adolf Hitler and Nazi Germany. The Trump campaign tells us this morning that this was a video that was shared by a staffer while the former president was in court and that staffer missed the reference, but it was still left up for several hours. Former President Donald Trump sparking backlash this morning after a video posted to his social media account seemingly suggests there will be a unified Reich if he wins the 2024 election.
Donald Trump wins. What's next for America?
Those words are largely associated with Nazi Germany and Adolf Hitler's Third Reich, another name for his Nazi regime. The 30-second video features hypothetical newspaper articles of Trump celebrating a victory in November. That phrase appearing three times, including under the headline, What's Next for America?
What the fuck?
It includes references to World War I, citing German industrial strength and peace through strength. Another headline suggesting Trump would reject globalists, a phrase often used by the far right as an anti-Semitic slur. In a statement, Trump campaign's press secretary says this was not a campaign video. It was created by a random account online and reposted by a staffer who clearly did not see the word while the president was in court.
The American dream is back.
The Trump campaign deleted the video after several hours, but it's not the first time Trump has used language similar to what Adolf Hitler once wrote. Just months ago, he declared immigrants are poisoning the blood of America.
They're poisoning the blood of our country. That's what they've done.
This morning, the Biden campaign issuing a statement saying Donald Trump is not playing games. He's telling America exactly what he intends to do if he regains power, rule as a dictator over a unified Reich.
That is insane. Former president and fucking unhinged, dude. Like, didn't he make another, like, didn't he make a lot of fucking statements about how he was, like, admiring Hitler, basically? Holy shit, I knew Bidenflation was bad, but didn't realize how bad. Yeah, for some reason, this seems like it's fake to me. I don't ever remember a time where you could get fucking French fries for $1.80. He's literally claiming food prices have doubled or tripled in some cases. Like, yeah, no. Oh yeah, 2024 source McDonald's app, Figuera Street, Los Angeles location selected, end of 2019. So yeah, this may just be certain locations. Why wouldn't he average price increase across these five items? 141. What do you mean average price? It's one location. Yeah, so it's just looking at one fucking location. You can add, because of the cost of rent or other costs in like a particular area, you can have prices in certain locations being much higher. The Predator donated $2. Never knew Trump was so based. Why did you completely misrepresent the conversation with Sean Baker? You and Rafaela didn't seem to understand a single word he said. She was hysterical the entire time. Your coaching has made her even worse. Well, thank you. Appreciate that. Thanks for the donation, The Predator.
People are the Iranian regime that is despised by so many people in Iran itself.
No, in Iran, we'll see during the funeral ceremonies how popular President Raisi was. Just like General Soleimani 4 years ago, people like you were saying the same thing about him. But we saw millions come to the street. Just because in the West you say this sort of thing doesn't mean that that's the reality on the ground over here. Hezbollah was a group that was created as a result of the Israeli regime's invasion of Lebanon. They went and captured the capital in 1982. Hezbollah was created as a result of this illegitimate and brutal occupation. They expelled the brutal apartheid ethno-supremacist regime from Lebanon. And oh, Hamas is, and other groups in Palestine are the result of 76 years of oppression, ethnic cleansing, and brutality and apartheid from this same regime. So when you speak
this
about
dude is
the Houthis
a psycho.
Or Ansarullah,
just a whack
you're talking
job.
About a decade of genocide carried out by the Saudis and the Emiratis, who are your allies, and your government were supporting them. Your government start.
Of course the price would go up on the Figueroa Street McDonald's. That's where all the prostitutes are.
Yeah, I don't know what you'd expect. Thanks for the donation, Pharaoh Enzo.
...of the people of Yemen to bring them to their knees, but you failed, and you failed today as well. So no, you cannot blame the victims. 9/11, we were told that Al-Qaeda carried out the attacks on the Twin Towers. Who was Al-Qaeda? They were working with you in Afghanistan. And then 10 years later in Syria and in Libya, Al-Qaeda was cooperating with you. We have an email from Jake Sullivan, February the 12th, 2012, where he sent that he sent to Hillary Clinton, where he said in Syria, Al-Qaeda is on our side. The dirty war in Syria, the dirty war in Libya is yours. These are your crimes and you cannot escape from it. So we are the victims and your ugly empire is guilty as it is guilty in the genocide today in Gaza.
I wonder how many people watching this around the world, and there'll be a lot, will look at the situation with the current Iranian regime and think the word victim is appropriate, particularly given that President Raisi, that you paint such a idyllic picture of as a human being, somebody who only cared about the downtrodden. This is a man, of course, ordered tighter enforcement of Iran's hijab and chastity law, restricting women's dress and behaviour. It was under those orders that 22-year-old Mahsa Amini was detained in September 2022 by Iran's morality police for wearing improper hijab and died 3 days later in hospital, sparking mass unrest. That doesn't sound like the kind of guy you're trying to describe to me. It sounds like a guy who is trying to dictate to women how they should dress, how they should behave.
Do you think the Palestinians would get more sympathy and support if Palestine wasn't led by an Islamist entity? While the removal of the Islamist aspect might not solve the conflict, it's hard not to think of the Islamism as having a tainting effect.
The reason why they get support throughout the Middle East is because they're predominantly Muslim. It doesn't seem to dissuade support from the West, so I doubt it. Yeah, if Palestinian Arabs weren't Muslim, I don't think you would have seen countries like Jordan try to come to their aid and support, like, the Antifada and shit. So it would probably end up being a net negative for them. Thanks for the donation, though, Goomba.
Do you understand that in the West, we look at that as reprehensible behavior?
No, in the West, you objectify women, you commodify women, and you sexualize women, and you have Epsteins and many Epsteins who control.
Or we give women the freedom to dress how they wish. Why would you decline them that freedom?
No, we in Iran, we have women pilots, we have women scientists. Mm. My boss at the University of Tehran, the dean of my faculty, is a woman. For the 21.
Yes, we have female pilots and scientists here too, you fucking retard. You know, this guy has the type of face, especially when he has that stupid smirk. Just want to punch him in the face. Like, what an annoying asshole.
Years that I've been an academic at the University of Tehran, 17 and a half of those years, the dean of my faculty was one woman or another. Don't misrepresent Iran. It doesn't work anymore, Pierce. Your Western empire is on the decline. The whole of the global South is witnessing the...
Oh, my God. The Western empire is in decline. Yeah. with the way things are going for Iran right now.
Crimes that are being carried out by your regimes, and your declining regimes are now despised by your own people. You're crushing people, students who are protesting genocide. You're not even crushing students who are protesting your own government for something that they're doing at home. You're crushing students for protesting genocide in another country, but you can't tolerate that. And your media is controlled by a group of rich people. They control the narrative, and you call that a democracy. Your choice is either Hillary Clinton or Biden or Trump. And then when that decision is made, the whole of Europe, Canada, the UK, Australia, and New Zealand fall in line as good soldiers. You don't have democracy, so don't pretend that you are above Iran.
Out of interest, Professor.
You owe us.
Out of interest.
You owe us.
Out of interest. Do you think women should have freedom to dress how they wish?
That is not your concern.
I'm asking you a question.
That is not your concern.
Do you have an answer for me or not?
Wow, this guy is such a dishonest loser.
Women should have a freedom to dress within the cultural context of every society. Women and men do not have the freedom to dress any way they like in your country. So different societies have different cultures.
I can dress how the hell I like.
Well, no, you cannot. You can then take off your clothes right now in front of the camera. Don't talk nonsense.
I can take my clothes off if I wanted to.
Every society has its own culture. We don't follow.
But just to be clear, I mean, you're trying to avoid the question. Just to be clear.
No, I'm not.
Well, just let me ask the question again. You're a smart guy, you're a professor, and you're full of the ills of the West. Do you think women should be free to dress how they like?
No, I told you. I told you very clearly.
You don't agree.
Women should have the freedom to dress the way they like, but in our culture, the sexualization, objectification, and commodification of women is unacceptable. It is your society that drives and pushes women
in
that
direction. Got it. Now, I get you another lecture about my society, but just to be clear, what you mean is you would like to just, you don't think they should, do you?
Women are pilots. Most of my university students are women. The last person who we hired in my department was a woman. I am an affiliate in another department as well at the University of Tehran. The last two people we hired as academics there are women too. You cannot misrepresent Iran.
I simply asked you, Professor, if you felt women should have the freedom to dress how they wish, and you cannot answer me because actually you don't think they should.
No, because I didn't. They should be free to dress as they like within the cultural and religious context.
And just to be clear, you can keep shouting, or you can answer my question. Just to be clear, that would be within the realm of Iran's hijab and chastity law, would it?
I don't know the precise law, and I'm not going to get involved in that debate. That's an internal
question. President Raisi, you tightened enforcement of that law, so you must be aware of it. You're a professor. You're a very smart guy.
No, actually, I hope you're smart too. Mr. Raisi did not tighten the law, or he didn't enforce it.
You just said you don't know anything about the law.
No, I don't know that.
You either know about it or you don't. Sounds like you're very well informed.
I know you're trying to escape the argument.
I'm just going to ask you a simple question. The truth is, this guy you're trying to paint as some kind of saint, right, was somebody who led...
This guy has noticeably become less comfortable now that he realizes he can't weasel out of this.
Enforcement of how women in Iran dress, and that led to a young woman who was being detained by your morality police. And because she was wearing an improper hijab, and she died in hospital 3 days later, sparking mass unrest where more people got punished. That's the reality of this utopia you paint in Iran. It's a place that actually, far from encouraging women to be these great champions, as you put it, actually wants to suppress and control them. And that was led by President Raisi. But anyway,
You want to keep talking because you want to run out the clock, because we know quite well, and so do you, that your regime and your government are the ones that are destroying our part of the world. And you're speaking about a law in Iran that most people accept and that it is part of a different culture than yours.
Yeah.
But you think that our society and all other societies...
When the law is enforced with brutal force, and if you don't abide by the law, you're fucking murdered... Hard to say that, most people accept the law. Well, yeah, they're going to get murdered otherwise.
Societies have to behave like yours, and that's not necessarily the case. And you think that necessarily because a woman wears a headscarf, that woman is somehow intellectually less or that she's oppressed?
I didn't say that.
Women, that is your ignorance.
If a woman chooses to do that, that's fine. It's the idea of people like you endorsing a law that orders them to dress in a certain way. I find objectionable.
It isn't fine, dude, because in the West, increasingly, women who have hijab are being sidelined. They're losing their jobs, whether it's in France, whether it's in England, and in other parts of Europe. So don't pretend that this is not the case. But in any case, women in Iran, whether they wear a headscarf or not, most of the university students in Iran are women. And women in Iran know how to deal with their rights much better than you. We don't need you, your government, and your filthy regime.
Is that why they all take to the streets to protest against the regime?
You will see women take to the streets during the funeral. And then...
Hi, VG. I really hope that you are doing great tonight. So, I knew that this day would finally come roar.
Let me take a look. Newsweek walks back report of Tucker Carlson launching Russian TV show. Conservative TV host Tucker Carlson launched a show on Russian state TV channel Rosia 24. Carlson interviewed Russian President Putin after traveling to Moscow. Program involves airing previous Carlson show episodes with Russian voiceovers. What the fuck? That is bizarre. Like, I don't know how the fuck you look at yourself in the mirror when this is happening and, like, not realize you're a fucking puppet for, you know, a fucking totalitarian regime. Thanks for the donation, though. Finger my ass. 21st Savage donated $2. What are you eating, fat ass? Donuts.
I really feel like he making everything harder for everybody. Got everybody jump through hoops, just do extra things.
They still need help. And I hate to say this, but people that are immigrants,
like, he'll get a bad.
Okay, so they're interviewing random retarded black people. Don't fucking care. Thanks for the donation, dude.
I will wonder how are you going to explain that away? Or is it North Korea and how the evil mullahs are forcing people to come to the streets?
Yeah, a lot of that. Yeah, a lot of that.
Yeah, I'm sure
absolutely
that's what
there is. Yeah, when you have a morality police, you get told what your morals should be and how to behave. That's the point of a morality police. Anyway, we've run out of time. We've run down the clock because I've given you more time than I intended to, Professor.
Just one final point. You have never been to Iran.
No.
You know nothing about Iran.
But I know many people who have.
No, you've never been to Iran.
And last time you came on this program, you tried to pretend that the regime has the widespread support of Iranian people. It doesn't. It doesn't.
Well,
in fact, it's believed as many as 80% of Iranian people loathe and despise your totalitarian regime.
In your wild dreams, that's the case, but you're the same person who gives a voice to the genocidal regime of Israel, and you advocate the devil.
Okay, well, we're going to have a member of the devil next on the program. Professor, thank you very much for coming back.
Thank you.
That guy was a fucking asshole, dude. Dude, I'd love to just punch him in his bitch mouth. Look at this fucking smug asshole. Dude, he just needs to get kicked really fucking hard in the groin. Cunt.
Thank you.
Let me see. What else do we got? Oh yeah, this should be good.
We're keeping the pressure up, the military pressure on Hamas.
You're an official spokesman for the Israeli government. David Harmon, the Israeli government spokesman. Thank you very much. Well, I'm joined now by the pro-Palestine journalist and commentator, Abby Martin, and by Mossad Hassan Youssef, the son of Hamas's founder and former leader, author of a new book, From Hamas to America. Welcome back to both of you. Abby Martin, I found that, I've got to say, a quite extraordinary interview. To be an official government spokesman and admit you have no idea how many civilians you've killed whilst trying to simultaneously compare yourself favorably to other civilian death ratios in war seemed to me staggering.
Indeed. I mean, especially since we have seen the comparison as the dust has been settling real time on our phones, we see Israel has committed, in fact, some of the most heinous war crimes in modern history, appears. And as we're seeing the invasion now of Rafah, cutting off the last vestige of escape for Palestinians, the last vestige of aid delivery, 1.3 million Palestinians, including 600,000.
The fuck does she mean, last vestige of aid delivery? There's aid trucks coming in every single fucking day.
Children with nowhere left to go. This is what Palestinians were told was a safe corridor. That is why they all fled to Rafah. Rafah has been bombarded for the last several weeks, killing dozens of people every day. So I think at this point, 6 months into a genocide, to be deliberating whether or not Israel should continue with this onslaught, this military operation that will result in mass slaughter to continue their ethnic cleansing of Gaza, is frankly absurd. Patently so, considering what we've seen them do just in the last several weeks, Piers. Evidence of summary executions of doctors, evidence of mass graves, hundreds of bodies bound, dozens of men, women, and children bound, evidence, according to the UN, of Palestinians buried alive, using drones to lure out Palestinians with sounds of crying children so they could be shot and killed. I mean,
I haven't seen verification of that claim fucking anywhere. And it doesn't even make any sense. Drones are loud as fuck. Like, if you have a fucking drone going overhead, it's going to make this, like, super loud buzzing noise. You're not going to be able to fucking blast, like, audio of a kid crying that's convincing from a fucking drone.
Unparalleled in modern history, actually. And the devastation that's occurred in the Gaza Strip, according to the UN, will take 80 years to rebuild without conditions. So at this point, Israel needs to be stopped before they continue this horrific onslaught, Piers.
Mossab, I'll get you to respond to what Abby just said, but just your response to that interview with an Israeli government spokesman, because I got to say, I found that pretty stunning that he would be so certain how many
Dodo donated $2. Saw some dumbass in chat say earlier they can't support either Trump or Biden, so they will vote Green Party. Jill Stein, can you explain to them why that's stupid? Also, like this vid, can you watch?
Black hole that's inside a black hole.
I'm not going to bother watching Kyrgyzat because they copyright claim channels and they spread misinformation all the fucking time. So, not interested. Voting for a third party candidate is just giving a vote for Trump. If you're taking away votes from Joe Biden to vote for a third party candidate, that's just going to ensure a Trump victory, you fucking moron. And the idea that Trump is just as bad as Joe Biden, again, you're a fucking moron. I don't know what to say. Like, you're just stupid. You're just fucking dumb.
Mass terrorists, the IDF have killed, but admit he had no idea how many civilians have been killed, given that it's the deaths of the civilians that is getting Israel so much unpopular reaction around the world.
Because we cannot send the Israelis to Rafah and to dangerous zones to collect statistics and count the numbers. It's a very dangerous zone. Israel is looking from the outside. And also, who said that Israel is only responsible for the killing of Gazans? Mostly Hamas responsible. First of all, for taking human shields. Second, they're booby traps. How could you differentiate the death that it was caused by an airstrike or by a Hamas death trap? How do we know the difference?
Well, yeah, but the point
war,
I would make
people
though,
die.
Yeah, but
listen to me. All this moral, Pierce. No, listen to me. All this dilemma. You know, you're going with your whatever morality. This is war. In war, people die. You need to wake up to this reality. Accept it. Stop this denial. We are in the face of savages who hijacked an entire society. This is a very difficult war. No other army can do the job, and I'm not willing to risk thousands of lives of foot soldiers to deal with this type of savages who hijacked the entire society. 100,000 people could have died. Israel is doing everything they could. Don't reduce it to the point. Do you have statistics? Who cares?
Well, actually,
Egypt,
no, I think you're missing my point.
Palestinian Authority,
yeah, Mossad,
Jordan,
all right.
The Arab world don't want Hamas at whatever cost.
Mossad.
Whatever it costs, we want to remove Hamas from power.
Okay, I understand that. That's a different question. My point is why...
Do you?
Well, why does... My question is this for you. Why is it that, if, as you say, Israel has no way of working out who's being killed here, and I know all about war... My brother served in wars in Iraq and Afghanistan. My brother-in-law served in wars. My grandfather served in wars. My uncle served in wars. I don't need a lecture about what warfare is, but I do find it surprising that Israel's official spokesman, months and months into this war, is able to tell me immediately how many Hamas terrorists have been killed by Israeli forces, but admits he hasn't got a clue how many civilians have been killed. And I'm sorry, I think most viewers,
because they can
most
count.
Viewers
they
will
can
find that stunning. You say Israel's no way of checking, but they seem
place.
To have a way of checking.
Sid donated $2. Let me see. Time for AIPAC to leave the stage. I think somebody already sent me this video. Basically, it's... what's her name? Fucking, trying to get another viral clip from the Young Turks. Just talking about how... oh, it's so awful that a foreign lobby group is pressuring U.S. Congress. Like, I don't fucking care. It's a shitty clip. Thanks for the donation, Sid.
U.S. Navy installing humanitarian aid pier on Gaza beach. Oh, on, humanitarian aid is not getting through, though. Lol.
Let me take a look.
Of the U.S. manufactured pier being installed against the Gaza coastline earlier today. That pier is now ready to facilitate the flow of humanitarian assistance to the Palestinian people in the Strip. Now, according to a statement by U.S. Central Command, they said this operation, this portion of the operation, is now complete and no U.S. forces set foot inside of Gaza. Now, the way the flow of humanitarian aid is going to take place is a little complicated. Big picture, aid will be inspected, delivered, inspected, and loaded into cargo ships in Cyprus, inspected by Israeli forces to ensure that it is only humanitarian aid flowing into the Strip. Those large container ships will then dock off the coast of Gaza at a floating dock that U.S. military has put together. From there, they will offload trucks or pallets to this floating dock that will be loaded into smaller ships. Those smaller ships then will set sail for this Gaza pier that was just attached. The trucks will offload at the pier, drive into Gaza, where the IDF has already established a presence there on the beach. They're likely to be inspected again, at which point the aid will be handed over to the United Nations for distribution. This is a video of...
yes, but it's a genocide, and they're trying to starve the Palestinians and blah, blah, blah. Let me see this one.
Your question around this pier that I've seen in comments here and across the United States, and it's a very understandable question, and I like that it's being asked, is what about the security of U.S. personnel? So a couple key notes. First off, there's no reason for U.S. personnel to be involved on the pier, in pier operations at this point. The U.S. constructed the pier. They attached the pier. There's no reason that the U.S. needs to be active on that pier at this point, from my understanding. It should be operated by the IDF. Now, there are going to be U.S. elements further out in the Mediterranean on a floating dock. Again, that is outside the range of anything that Hamas could strike it with. Hamas has rockets that can go that far, but not something that's going to be accurate enough to strike a small dock out in the middle of the ocean. Hezbollah does have the capabilities to strike that. Unclear if they would actually want to or not. But either way...
how many Hamas they're killing, Mossad?
Listen, it's Israel's responsibility to know the death of their own citizens. This is their responsibility. I think your question was absurd. This is why you put him on the spot. He was not prepared for it.
I didn't put him on the spot.
But this is not the reality on the ground. The reality on the ground, Hamas must go. The only side want Hamas to stay is the Iranian Ayatollah. And for some stupid reason, Karen in America wants Hamas to stay. But the Arab world, let me tell you something, Jordan, Egypt, Saudi Arabia, the majority of the Arab world, we are Arabs. I am Arab. We are not Palestinians. We don't want Hamas. We don't want Islam. We want Islamists out of power.
Okay.
It's as simple as that.
All right.
They have been killing Jewish and Arab children.
All right.
This is not your game. This is not her game. It's not about statistics.
It's not a game.
It's about doing the correct thing of removing Hamas from power.
Mossad.
End of the story.
Let me interrupt, because you quoted Saudi Arabia in your rant there. So let me read you a statement from the Saudi Foreign Ministry. The Ministry of Foreign Affairs expresses the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia's warning of the dangers of the Israeli occupation forces targeting the city of Rafah as part of a systematic bloody campaign to storm all areas of Gaza Strip and displace its residents towards the unknown in light of a lack of safe zones after the massive destruction caused by the Israeli war machine. The Ministry affirms the Kingdom's categorical rejection of the occupation forces' continued blatant violations of international resolutions, calling for the cessation of these massacres and their violation violation of international law and international humanitarian law without deterrence, which exacerbates the humanitarian crisis and limits international peace efforts. The ministry renewed the kingdom's demand for the international community to intervene immediately to stop the genocide carried out by occupation forces against defenseless civilians in the occupied Palestinian territories. So when you say all Arabs agree with you, Mossad, actually they don't. That is the Saudi foreign ministry saying they want it to stop right now.
As we speak, the intelligence services of the Arab world.
They'll all say this, but will they accept a single Palestinian refugee? Of course not. They don't care. This has more to do with hating Jews than it does about helping Palestinians.
All of them in a joint operation room with Israel to rid of Hamas. I don't care about some politician trying to make a political statement. It's false. The reality on the ground, we don't want Hamas. We don't want Islamists. We don't want this anarchy, this revolution without a moral compass. We don't want to globalize it. We don't want to bring it to the United States. The game is over. Hamas is out and their death warranty has been issued. It's a finished job.
All right,
and we are going into Rafah and we are going to eliminate every last one of them.
Okay, let me bring in Abby. Abby, you've been listening to this. I mean, fundamentally, I understand why Israel and Israelis want to eliminate Hamas completely, because this is a terror group who are wedded to the eradication of Israel and everybody in it. In fact, they have reiterated publicly, through their official spokesman, a desire to commit as many October the 7th as they can. So I completely understand why Israel wants to get rid of these terrorists. The question is, how do they do that without killing many, many more civilians? And as we saw from the Saudi statement, there are many Arab countries now in the region increasingly concerned that if there is a full attack on Rafah, which has 1.5 million people, a lot of civilians are going to die.
Right. And to your point before, I think the death toll is actually vastly undercounted, considering how we have not even began to excavate the bodies under the rubble. So I would say that the death toll is a vast undercount. As far as Mossab's point about Hamas,
no evidence of undercounting.
I think that, you know, Mossab is the Palestinian who hates Palestinians. He's developed a lucrative career being able to lie about basic facts about this conflict. And so when he says Palestinians or Hamas, what he really means is all Arabs and all Muslims. In fact, I've seen that plain as day in his social media and talks. He thinks that all Muslims are terrorists. And so, I mean, this is credited to the point that he is actually credited to jailing.
Have you ever met a Muslim who wasn't a terrorist? Let's be honest.
What is called the Mandela, the Palestinian Mandela. Marwan Barghouti, this is a guy who he put in prison 20 years ago, who was marching side by side with Israeli peace activists denouncing Hamas killing civilians. So again, I mean, when we're looking at someone who's worked for an Israeli intelligence, who spouts the same rhetoric as Israelis, who say Hamas, but what they really mean is all Palestinians, I mean, it's really hard to debate someone on the fundamental reality and the principles of, you know, the facts of this conflict. Now, to your point, Piers, about what should they do about Hamas, I reject the premise of Israel's genocide. I'm not going to sit here and say, yes, Hamas.
Oh, my God. Every time you, like, they bring up, oh, it's a genocide, la, 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 like, it's so bad. So, okay, so what should we do about Hamas? Hamas is bad, but I reject the genocide. Yeah, but what should we do about Hamas? Like, what should Israel's response be? Well, they should try to have peace. Like, it's always nothing.
Hamas is a terrorist organization and they need to be eradicated. Of course, that's not true. And I think that we can both agree.
What do you mean that's not true?
It's an impossible task. It's not true that something needs to be done about Hamas. I don't agree with that framework and the parameters of that debate.
Why?
She thinks Hamas should just keep existing and Israel should have no military action against them. Even Pierce is like, what? Look at his face. He's like, what the fuck? That's the stupidest shit I've ever fucking heard in my life. Yeah, let's see. This terrorist group lobs rockets into Israel, thousands of them. It's costing the Israeli military tens of millions of dollars each month. just to run that fucking Iron Dome system. Sometimes hundreds of millions each month to run the Iron Dome. They're killing innocent civilians. There are terror attacks coming out of both Gaza and the West Bank constantly. And then they just massacre 1,200 fucking Israeli civilians. The worst massacre against Jews since the Holocaust. Well, I don't think anything has to be done about Hamas. Like, they're just fine. Jews just have to die. Like, what a fucking wacko anti-Semite.
Because Israel's been committing ethnic cleansing and genocidal policies against the Palestinians for 70
plus years. But Hamas literally has a charter. Yeah, but Abby, hang on. Hamas literally has a stated charter of the elimination of Israel. That is the purest personification of a publicly stated policy of genocide I can imagine.
That's not true. Their revised charter says that
oh my God. Okay, the revised charter does not dismiss, it doesn't get rid of the claim that they want to destroy all Jews. They have a revised charter that doesn't mention the killing of Jews, but that doesn't mean they don't want to kill Jews. No one has ever walked back the claim that they don't want to kill Jews anymore. So that's just total bullshit.
They actually recognize the existence of the Israeli state among 1967 borders. That's the revised charter, and they actually make a political differentiation between Zionism and Judaism. That's
so
the actual charter
of Hamas.
To a random spokesperson. Yeah.
Yeah, but he's not random. He's the official spokesman for Hamas, and he said literally 2 weeks after October the 7th, we are going to do this again and again and again. That is an existential genocidal threat to the existence of everyone in Israel. Clearly, said publicly on camera. I mean, he's brazen about it.
Look. I think that when you're comparing one guy and his statement to literally dozens of genocidal statements, okay, but look at the official spokespeople of Israel, Piers, and look at the actual genocide they're committing. You cannot compare the two. It's a complete false equivalency. One guy is saying one thing. The other dozens of Israeli ministers and cabinet officials and public media personas on TV are saying one thing and actually doing it on the ground.
You would allow Hamas to stay in power?
On the ground. It's not up to me, Piers. Hamas is representative of a large...
You've been expressing many opinions.
Okay, but here's the thing.
What's your opinion?
Marwan Barghouti...
That is such a bullshit cop-out. It's not up to me. Well, nothing is up to you. He's asking your opinion on whether or not Hamas should stay on power, you fucking gaslighting bitch.
Marwan Barghouti is the most popular unifying figure in Palestinian society. He would resoundingly win in an election against Hamas. So what this is...
No, he wouldn't. Hamas has clear, overwhelming popularity. That's idiotic.
This isn't about Hamas. This is about eliminating every faction of Palestinian resistance, peaceful or not. It is not about Hamas.
It's all
about
what Hamas did on October the 7th.
But Piers, I think we both know it's not. Because what is the military occupation founded upon?
Wilder and Pappy Mango don't know what I am talking about with this cauliflower ice cream. It looks so fucking good. Could we react? We don't have to watch the whole thing.
Speaking of
things
that need to be atoned for, I have unfortunately finally a deeply unsettling, tragic, really disturbing video to play for you.
This New Zealand startup is making ice cream out of cauliflower, and they're on a mission to help the world eat differently. This plant-based ice cream is made without any dairy, gluten, nuts, or soy. The two female founders, Millie and Jenny, came up with the idea and started making ice cream here in New Zealand using cauliflower.
I haven't tasted it, so it could be good.
You know that I'm not joking when I say that that should be illegal. I really believe that. It should be illegal.
He hasn't even tasted it, and yeah, it's horrible. He's just made up his mind. Okay. Thanks for that, Nation Axel.
When did Hamas come into power? We know that this isn't just about Hamas. What was Israel doing in the West Bank the year prior to October 7th? They killed 500 Palestinians, 80 children. This is ethnic cleansing. This is a military occupation. As long as you have these policies in place, you will never get to the root of the violence, Piers.
All right, Mossab, there was an allegation there that you think all Muslims are terrorists. What's your response to what Abby Martin said?
Well, you know, this is Abby's desperate attempt to discredit me. I am a man of the field. I fought against Hamas as part of intelligence, legitimate intelligence organization, against savage group that were targeting civilians in suicide bombing attacks, waves of suicide bombing attacks that they killed people indiscriminately. So Abby today want me for some reason to apologize for saving human life because my...
Most leftists should be blended into cannibal smoothies. Most of them have absolutely no thoughts on Russia's genuine intent to eradicate Ukraine. In fact, they will victim blame Ukrainians for wanting trade with the West. Simps for terrorism.
Yeah. There's a lot of lefties like Hassan Piker, fucking moron, who have really dumb takes on Ukraine. It's really fucking stupid. Just everybody is an idiot, man. It's just amazing how society has gotten to this point when so many people are absolute fucking retards. Like, I really am genuinely amazed how this whole human project has succeeded until now. Like, everyone is a fucking idiot. They don't know who to vote for. Like, none of the political information they get is accurate. Like, how the fuck have we not elected, like, another Hitler? And then, like, there's another genocide and we all wipe ourselves out with nuclear bombs. I don't know how it hasn't happened yet. It's miraculous. Thanks for the donation, though, Caleb.
My truth challenges her convenient truth. Abby does not have the authority. She's just a self-appointed low-grade journalist. How can you be a journalist and you call this a genocide, ethnic cleansing? And she just keep repeating ethnic cleansing, genocide, colonialism, etc. None of it is real, including Palestine. It's all in your head. None of it is existential. Palestine was never born. How can you free it? It was never there. It's just a colonial entity, and some people choose to make it into a national identity. And this parrot has been just repeating Hamas propaganda. Marwan Barghouti, that she's talking about him, she never met him. I knew Marwan before he got to power. He's a criminal. He killed five people. He has blood on his hands. He cheated on his wife. He has a secret son that he never revealed it to the public. Of course, I can criticize him, and I can criticize all the criminals that I know personally. She's been there only for a visit, and maybe she had some falafel sandwich, you know, and she really was blown away of the Palestinian experience. There is no such a thing as Palestine. It's about time to retire. Find a different job. You're not a journalist. You don't qualify even to be a mother.
Wow. Abby.
Mossab, you know, it's usually a public figure. If they were caught lying about half the things that they said, they would be completely discredited and never allowed airtime. You are spewing such ahistorical anti-Arab bigotry that not even the fringe of Israeli society would agree with you. I mean, not even Israeli historians agree.
I'm not anti-Arab. Sir. I am Arab. This is my ethnicity. Sir. Islam is just
anti-Muslim
a
bigotry.
I am not a Muslim.
Anti-Muslim bigotry. Yeah, if you hate, let's see, sex slavery, mass murder, child rape, slavery, unequal human rights, women being second-class citizens. You're an Islamophobe. Oh, you hate Muslims. You're Islamophobic. You're supposed to love rape and murder and genocide and slavery.
We are Arabs.
Mossab. Okay. Then anti-Muslim bigotry, which is frankly appalling considering that there's a billion people on the planet who would be characterized as you as, you know, extremists who need to be used force against, according to you. But Mossab, not even Israeli historians would agree with the fact that you claim that there's no military occupation in the West Bank, that there's no apartheid state. Israelis at least admit, yes, those things exist, but here's why they're necessary.
Caleb says, I hate Islam. Well, same here. This is definitely a Muslim-hating channel. Doesn't mean I hate Muslim people, but Islam itself, Absolutely. I hate Islam.
Necessary and justified. They don't even agree with you. You're so fringe that I don't even know where you're coming from. I mean, so again, if we can't even agree with the basic facts of the conflict and the reality in front of our eyes, I don't know how we can really even discuss this.
Well, sir?
Yeah, because you don't qualify.
Well, I think it's the belittling her credentials. Listen, well, everyone's entitled to an opinion.
Listen, Pierce, best case scenario, if there is an occupation, it's between Israel and Jordan, or it's between Israel and Egypt, because it was not an occupation of a country called Palestine. There was never Palestine in history. This is not an absurd statement. It's reality. Palestine never exists. There was not a country.
There was never anywhere on the map called Palestine.
It was not a nation. It's not an ethnic group. We are Arabs. We are the Arabs of Judea and Samaria. And when I was born, like millions of Palestinians, we had Jordanian birth certificate. The people of Gaza were Egyptian with Egyptian birth certificate. There was no Palestine. Yasser Arafat created this entity, and everybody believed him. And this lie must die. This is why I don't like what Abby and her likes doing by trying to delegitimize Israel. She's trying to discredit me. Who gave you the authority? How dare you?
You are a spy. You're a spy for Israeli intelligence, Masab.
It is not funny. It's not funny.
She is criticizing him for being a spy for Israeli intelligence when he's probably saved the lives of hundreds of people by preventing terrorist bombings. Like... This woman is batshit insane.
Funny, your tale,
it's
your
not
false
funny at
narrative
all.
Need to
it's,
stop because
it's
you
not
are
funny
creating
at all,
chaos.
Masab.
Listen, Abby, you are bringing
Masab,
chaos
very...
to the United States and you will be held accountable. You are just
okay.
A criminal like them.
Sure. Okay, Masab, you can't be taken seriously and you're not legitimate because you are literally, you have worked for Israeli intelligence to out your own people. But listen,
sooner
okay, but Masab,
or later
you can't
you
discredit
realize.
My reality as well. You can't discredit my reality as well. I was in the West Bank. I had assault rifles
then
pointed at my head from a 17-year-old American from Palo Alto.
You,
that's an occupation.
You are in my domain
Masab.
Right
that's
now.
That's a military occupation.
Okay, you are in my domain. When you come to my domain, you have to pay respect. You have to respect all the effort that I put to save human lives, and you cannot reduce that into some
why,
propaganda because
why
it's
on
not,
earth would I respect
it's not about
you for
Israel,
putting
it's
the
about...
leader of Fatah, Masab, you put the most unifying popular Palestinian figure, you are credited to putting him in prison. This is someone who would win an election against Hamas. He is...
Right, the guy who is planning terrorist bombings. How dare you?
He's a peace activist. He was fighting for a two-state solution. This isn't about Hamas, and you know it. This is about you shutting down, tamping down on all factions of Palestinian society. And let's be clear, what is Palestine supposed to do? What are Palestinians supposed to do when in 2018, thousands of Palestinians in Gaza marched peacefully to this fortified perimeter fence that Israeli snipers have authorized themselves to shoot to kill, and that's exactly what they did. They massacred over two...
They didn't mass. Oh my god, dude! If the reason the perimeter fence exists in the first place is because of fucking terror attacks. So, oh, what are poor Palestinians supposed to do? They're enclosed by a border fence. The border fence is there because they committed acts of terror. If they didn't commit acts of terror, there wouldn't be that border fence. And then when these dumb fucks knowingly approach a fucking border fence, knowing there's snipers there. Knowing they're not allowed to cross, knowing they're going to get targeted by Israeli snipers, and then they actually get shot. Oh, how dare you shoot them? Like, this is fucking retarded. This is like me banging on somebody's door, telling them, I'm going to break in, I'm going to fucking rape your daughter. And then they're like, don't come through the door, I'm going to shoot you, I'm going to rape your daughter, bang, bang, bang. And then I break through the door and I get shot. How could you do this to me? Oh, I was just trying to cross your fucking door. Like, oh my god.
200 peaceful demonstrators, medics, press, Journalists, clearly marked press, disabled people in wheelchairs, and children. These are all violations of international law in the Geneva Convention.
No, it's not. No, it's not. No, it's not. No, 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 no. This is all bullshit. It's not violation of international law. It's not violation of the Geneva Convention. You're just a fucking moron. You don't know what you're talking about.
Off one by one in a methodical slaughter over the course of several months. That's when Palestinians tried to peacefully protest. So I think the question should be, what should Palestinians do? Because they're not even allowed to advocate for their legal rights. They're not even allowed to raise up a Palestinian flag.
Oh, what should they do? So she's actually advocating for terrorism. She's a Hamas supporter, and she's saying, well, obviously they have to murder innocent civilians and rape women and burn people alive. What else are they supposed to do? What a fucking moron. Like, by the way, Israel offered a land for peace deal back in the 1980s. And guess what? Palestinians not only rejected it, but it sparked the second Intifada, where they actually tried to, again, attack Israel, make all these terror attacks after they were given a land for peace deal. Like, what the fuck are, like, what are Israelis supposed to do? They say, hey, we want to have peace. We don't want to fight anymore. We're willing to give you all this land. Can you negotiate? No! Bang, bang, bang! Allahu Akbar! Boom! That's what they get. So what is Israel supposed to do? Obviously, they have to do a genocide and ethnic cleansing. Yeah, this is literally her fucking brain dead take.
I visited a place called Sebastia in the occupied West Bank, and Palestinians were shot and in the hospital for simply erecting a Palestinian flag on a hilltop several days prior. This is the brutal reality of military occupation in the West Bank, Masab. I mean, I want the violence to end. I empathize with the victims of both sides of this.
Do you?
And that's why I want to get to the root of the conflict. Yes, I don't go out there and say Jews can't be trusted like you say about Muslims. I empathize with all civilian life. I believe
then
and cherish the sanctity of
lies.
Human life. And that's why I want to get to the root of why violence occurs,
Masab.
Let me ask Masab a question.
Do you agree with the principle that Palestinians right. should be entitled to exactly the same human rights as Israelis?
Listen, the suffering of the Arabians, again, stop calling them Palestinians. They are not Palestinians. We are Arabs. We are the Arabs of Judea and Samaria. And Israel and the Jewish people
well,
have
Palestinians
no problem
call
since the beginning of their state. Well, you gave them that name. You forced the international community and the rest of the world.
All right,
well,
let me rephrase the question. Should the people who live in Gaza and on the West Bank, should they be entitled to the same human rights as Israelis?
If they have equal responsibility as the decent citizens of the state of Israel, that includes Arabs, Druze, Christians, and all other citizens of the state of Israel, then yes, they have equal rights. But if they are not taking their responsibility, if they are using violence, sending suicide bombers, and killing babies, kidnapping a one-year-old, you know, how do you answer to the mother and to the mothers of the hostages and all those who got killed on October 7th? You know, it's very easy.
Just hit force. It's 525 unconventional deadlift with no straps. Dope, dude. It's pretty goddamn strong.
To just try to delegitimize Israel, this is what Abby and her likes have been trying to do for so long. But they don't have the moral power to say what Hamas did, all the waves of suicide bombing attacks, October 7th. That was a genocide. That was a genocide. So stop spreading the false narrative. Now, regarding to the Arabs who live there, they need a decent police force. They need a good economy. They need good education. And if they are able to integrate, then naturally could be a political entity based on their needs. But right now, when she say Palestine, who is? Islamic Jihad? Fatah, Marwan Barghouti, Ismail Haniyeh, Hamas, Public Front, They are so conflicted. We don't have even, they don't have agenda. They don't have leadership. They don't have legitimacy. This is an anarchy that has been going on for about 70 years. And it's about time for it to stop. Now to transform, to integrate the society, we must protect the children.
React to this outreach for a little bit if you have time. Do you think she'll go vegan? Always appreciate your feedback, bro.
Let me take a look. Thanks for the donation, Harry.
Hello, how are you doing today?
I'm good, how are you?
I'm glad you're doing good. Where are you from?
I'm from Los Angeles.
Los Angeles? I mean...
Whoa, look at that butt in the background. That's a nice big butt.
Amazing. So do you eat animals personally, right?
Yes, I eat meat.
Do you find that morally problematic, or you think it's fine to just kill others and eat them?
I feel guilty for it at times, but it's been so normal in my life that I continue to do so.
Yeah, same. Likewise, we're raising like carnist cultures. We're raised thinking this is okay.
Absolutely.
But like, let me ask you this: like hypothetically, if we were doing the same sort of thing we're doing to animals, like bringing them into existence and slaughtering them for sandwiches.
Why don't you try 12.5 to 50 milligrams with ketapine? It works like magic for sleep. You can ask your doctor to write you a script for Sandoz brand 100 milligrams. They are very easy to cut in 2 or 4, so 50 or 25 milligrams.
I'm not convinced sleep medication actually helps you to get sleep. I've seen some sleep experts talk about sleep medications, and they don't seem to help you get into the deep REM sleep required to actually benefit from sleep. So, I don't know. I have been given meds before to help me get to sleep. If this keeps continuing, I'll ask. But yeah, it's only been for the last, like, week or so. Thanks for the donation, though, VG. Dodo donated $2. Let me see.
Kim Jong-un is threatening the world with endless missile tests. You might be thinking, what's new? We're used to North Korea's leader Kim Jong-un being presented either as a supervillain or laughed off in dictator jokes. But now some North Korea
Rocket
watchers
Man.
Are sounding the alarm. Saying Kim might actually want a war.
How big? When? Don't know.
Kim seems to be sick of trying to make peace, and things are working out in his favor.
These days, Kim is very emboldened.
That's a threat, especially for South Korea, which is backed by the US. So is the frozen conflict between North Korea and South Korea heating back up? And is Kim more dangerous than ever? There. Now North Korea has repeatedly fired artillery into the waters around the islands as a threat. North Korea has been unhappy about this border for decades. Now Kim seems done with tolerating it. He called it illegal.
It seems to me he wants that clash for some reason. He wants that to happen, and he's preparing for it.
At the end of World War II, the totalitarian, and Kim started building a North Korean region right on the border with both China and Russia. It's a special economic zone, which means this is where the communists... These missile launches used to have a different purpose.
The idea that they were always so dangerous was mistaken. The North Koreans did not want to go to war before. The whole purpose of their policy was to engage the Americans, not to go to war with them.
In other words, weapons testing was kind of part of their diplomatic policy, a way to make sure South Korea, and more importantly, its superpower backer, the US, kept talking to them. That takes us back to the DMZ. It looked pretty good when these meetings were happening there a few years ago. South Korean President Moon Jae-in and Kim Jong-un were taking steps to try and finally end the war. Because remember, the two Koreas never officially made peace. And US President Donald Trump made a surprise appearance. He also came to visit the DMZ, and was actually the first U.S. president ever to set foot into North Korean territory. Many didn't take the meetings between the two seriously, but actually,
there were clear signs that Kim Jong-un really was willing to do something, right? And something on his nuclear weapons program.
So Kim may have been willing to give up a lot in return for sanctions relief. But at their summit in Hanoi, the talks collapsed.
Now, there's a lot of sexy-ass North Korean women that I've seen. Yeah, there's some fine North Korean bitches. Yeah, she's cute. She's pretty cute. Yeah, she's cute. She's cute. What's this? They're fucking cute. Damn, those girls are fucking sexy. Holy shit. Yeah, dude, it's too fucking bad, eh? So many fucking fine-ass women there. Yeah, they're really fucking cute. Goddamn.
Jesse, if we were to be doing that with humans, would you say it would be a moral obligation for us not to give our money to that? Or would you say it would be fine to pay for human meat?
No, obviously we have a moral obligation to protect humans and make sure they're okay.
I'm glad we have common ground on that. Yeah,
absolutely.
Sure. What do you think is true of animals that if it was true of humans, would make it okay to do that sort of thing to humans?
I think the only thing that some people may say is...
No, you. Like, I want you to reflect on your own values. I know some people use all sorts of excuses, right? But what do you think is so morally different between us and animals that justifies doing that to them?
I think that we have a moral compass.
Mm-hmm. It's so weird when people say, well, we have a moral compass, we have moral agency. That's what differentiates ourselves from animals, so that makes it okay to kill animals. So we have a moral compass, but we turn off our moral compass to kill and eat animals. But that's what separates us from animals. Like, it's so stupid.
I mean by that?
Like, we know the difference between right and wrong, which doesn't mean we should take advantage of animals. But I think humans think because they're not able to express with us how they feel that it's okay to...
You know, by the way, it's so weird when people say animals don't have moral agency. They do. They absolutely do have moral agency. If they didn't have moral agency, they wouldn't be able to operate in social groups. They might not be able to understand the concept of moral agency or morals, but they do have some degree of moral agency. They will have some kind of sense of right and wrong. Like again, they wouldn't be able to operate in social groups if they didn't. Son Goku donated $2. Would you say Joey Swole is an attention whore? Let me take a look.
When you hop on a canoe with a random family in Hawaii and Lil Bro doesn't know how to act.
Filming a minor to post on social media to shame him.
Who the fuck cares, dude? He does video after video after fucking video like that. Who fucking cares? Yeah, he's an attention whore. He's found like a weird, like, Karen niche of complaining about fucking dumb bitches online who fucking complain about dumb bitch shit. Yeah, like, who fucking cares? Thanks for the donation, Son Goku.
Kill them. To eat.
Oh, okay, I understand what you mean.
Understand?
But do you also, like, do you admit that there are some marginal cases of humans that don't have that moral compass? Let's...
What happened to your horse? Well, the horse is doing just fine, and he's doing horse things on a nice paddock. And do I drive? I don't have a driver's license for a car, but I do have my motorcycle license.
Picture like mentally disabled humans. Let's say we found a group of mentally disabled humans to the same degree of animals. Should we stab them and eat them, or do you think we should also extend basic human rights to them?
Extend basic human rights, of course.
So that would there create a contradiction. That wouldn't be the trait that justifies it, right?
Absolutely.
So can you picture any other like trait of or set of traits that's true of animals that if it was true of humans would make you have that same attitude where you would like pay for the meat of the human, or?
Absolutely not.
You don't know any like any, you can't think of any morally significant difference between us and animals that justifies doing that to them?
No. It's morally
it sounds
wrong.
Like you have. It sounds like you have vegan values then.
I've tried.
It is morally
I've
wrong.
I've tried
right?
veganism, but it's very difficult to obtain because in the normal restaurant we have meat and.
Okay, but before we go there, I'm happy to talk about that. But do you concede then that it is morally obligatory to be vegan? Because I think it is a logical extension of human rights. You said it is a morally.
Yeah, I'm going to get a driver's license, and I might be able to get an aerial atom in the next few years, maybe.
It's obligatory not to give your money to an industry that stabs humans for food,
yes,
but for some reason it's not a moral obligation to do that in the animal context. Or do you think it is also a moral obligation to be vegan and not stab animals?
I mean, I think we have choice, but after this conversation it gets you questioning what is morally correct. Should I be eating animals? Should I be taking their milk? He pointed out the picture of the cow, you know, like, who's this for?
So what do you think? Should you be doing that? It sounds like from the answers you gave, you haven't found like a justification to support that.
I haven't yet, but I think
You mentioned convenience. You mentioned it's hard to be vegan. What do you think, what makes you think it's hard? I mean, I find it super easy, especially when you think about the victims.
Absolutely. I think for me, it's more the money aspect. Being vegan, from what I've seen, you know, you go to a restaurant specified that's vegan or even vegetarian items are usually up-priced in comparison with animals.
Do you think that's universally true about all plant-based foods? Just think about this. What are the cheapest in any country, including here, including the States? What are the cheapest foods you can get your hands on, typically?
Fruits and vegetables? No?
It's things like grains, like rice, beans, lentils, potatoes.
Like, when somebody gives me an answer like this, where they don't really know what the cheapest foods are, that suggests to me that either they're still living with their parents and they don't pay for their food, or they make so much money that they never have to consider how much they spend at the grocery store.
Pasta, absolutely. All that shit is vegan, right? So all the cheapest foods that you can think of are all vegan. And it is, you can survive out of that. Also, like mock meats, like tofu, seitan, soy meat, all that stuff is super cheap nowadays and widely available. So it is possible to be vegan and you know, on a budget or whatever. So if you were to look into it, and you would realize that yeah, being vegan is actually not only possible but pretty easy, would you then say it is like morally obligatory to be vegan?
Do I think it's morally illegal or legal?
No, morally obligatory, and by that I mean that it would be wrong not to be vegan.
I think if everyone had access to it, yes.
Well, I don't know about everyone, but let's say if you had access to it, and you do, like we do, is it then the right thing to go vegan? If you don't go vegan, is it the wrong thing?
I feel bad. I from this conversation, I feel like it's morally incorrect to continue to eat meat and animal products. But at the end of the day, I do truly believe that everyone has a choice, and what they want to do is, you know, this is what
sure,
we
do have a choice. We do have a choice, but how about the choice of the animals not to? I mean, personally, they want to live, so why not respect their choice, right? As well. Like, wouldn't you say that if you stab somebody to death, you're, like, not respecting their choice?
Well, absolutely.
And that's what we're doing to animals, right? Because we have a choice. We can pick the vegan. We can just do this. And instead of picking the carnist option, pick the vegan option. They don't have a choice, right? But you do, right?
How did we start this, though? Like, why did we start eating animals then?
First, I just want to really like get to understand your values if you actually see it as morally obligatory. I do, like, because you wouldn't have the same attitude in any other context. Let's say somebody was stabbing dogs and eating them, or baby humans.
Absolutely.
You wouldn't say it's his choice, right? You would say, get that man in prison, right?
Absolutely.
Yeah. So, and there's really nothing so different between us and animals that justifies doing that to them. We're all sentient. We have brains, a capacity.
Someone was saying I was bad for being pro-Israel because of the innocent civilian deaths, the relentless bombing, and humanitarian aid. What do I say to that? Tell them they're cucked retards who don't understand national security. Like, as if Israel has any other choice at this point but to go to war. The Iron Dome to Israel has to use the Iron Dome to protect themselves from Hamas rocket strikes. In one single month, it cost Israel about $500 million to protect themselves against Hamas rocket strikes. Hamas has committed an innumerable amount of terror attacks, the worst being October 7th. Like, no other country in the fucking planet would accept those sorts of losses, where you have thousands of innocent civilians being killed by a militant group living right next to you. You're losing hundreds of millions of dollars in military equipment to protect yourself from this militant group. Israel has to go to war with Hamas, and the only reasonable way to go about doing that is by bombing the shit out of Gaza. Like, ask them, okay, what should Israel do? They're probably going to say something stupid like, Israel should make peace. Like, that's like saying, oh, well, the U.S. should have made peace with Hitler. Like, okay, that's not going to fucking happen. I've heard stupid fucking idiots like Jenk say, oh, send in the special forces. Yeah, send in Solid Snake and Sam Fisher from Metal Gear and Splinter Cell. They'll get the job done. Like, they just don't know what the fuck they're talking about.
For consciousness, subjective experience, but that's what really matters morally, and we share that with animals. So how do we start? Yeah, by educating yourself about it, basically. That's where you start.
I think that's the most important thing. You know, what you guys are doing, coming out here and talking about it, getting conversations starting, is so important, because a lot of people are just uneducated. It's just
Joey has all the sentience.
Oh my god. Whoa. Oh my god. You can see the sentience right here. Right there, that's where all the sentience is. Why? Oh my god.
Why there?
Whoa. Look at him. Look at how handsome. Oh my god, I want him. I'm going to steal your kitty and keep him for myself. I want him. That is a good kitty. Oh my god. Thanks for the donation, Ethan, though.
Generations.
I don't think most people are bad. I think most people just don't know. Most people are ignorant.
Finger my ass when I tell others burbs. Let me see. Ooh. Kookaburra. Give him snack. Give him a snack. That's a nice kookaburra. Oh my god, what the hell is this? How did that happen? They literally built a nest on this gazelle's head? Well, the gazelle seems okay with it. That's nice.
Siska. Over here, and then...
Aw, little babies. That's nice. She helped. I saw some baby geese the other day. I fucking love baby geese. Thanks for the donation, finger my ass.
about it. I hate the action, not the actor. Most people are ignorant about it.
Yeah, absolutely. I think in my own life, it's just since I was a baby, I was put a plate of meat in front of me, and that's what I ate, you know? I never thought about the moral obligation of the animals and how I could be harming them in the long end.
And you
but
do
I'm
agree.
I'm glad you're having this conversation.
I'm glad you're so open about it, and
of course,
so amazing. So you agree that, you know, we're brought into this world, but there's all sort of traditions, and some of them are pretty bad, and we should abolish those traditions.
Oh, absolutely.
Human slavery comes to mind.
Yeah.
Women not having rights to vote, and
yes,
to
absolutely.
Comes to mind the LGBTQ marginalization. Yeah, we just think we
that
should.
That toad you saw at 3 a.m. looked like a cute little guy. Yeah. I picked him up and put him in some grass. Toads feel so fucking weird. It's like picking up a like thick sentient penis. It they feel really weird in your hand. But that was a nice toad.
Enlarge the circle of moral consideration to animals as well. And it seems like you agree, and it seems like you have vegan values. The only way to align your actions with your values is to choose vegan.
Absolutely.
I ask you one last question. Next time you're out shopping, are you going to choose compassion, or are you going to choose to exploit others?
Ooh, that's a big question. The way you worded it is quite scary. I'm going to try my best, and I'm going to continue to educate myself and see what my values align with. But I'm very glad we had this conversation.
I'm very glad you had that conversation too. I just wanted to realize how you weren't able to point like a morally significant distinction, because personally in the human context, if you were right now eating humans already and you had a choice to go vegan overnight, would you go vegan overnight, or would you like, I'm gonna educate myself, you know, I'm
no,
gonna take
absolutely.
It slow.
Absolutely, I'm gonna take
yeah.
the...
And I want you to see that in the same way in the animal context, because it is a moral emergency, and it's like we should do it, like,
now.
For them, like, because mm-hmm. how many animals do you want to...
die before we...
Yeah, get exploited in your name specifically, because you're the one giving your money, right? So you're one more person financing, you know, supply and demand, right?
Of course.
If we're one less person giving our money to that shit... You know, we're helping.
Yes.
Yeah.
And inspiring others. Yeah, no, absolutely. This is a very good conversation.
Thank you so much. I just would point you to the scientific evidence. You should read into, like, the Academy of Nutrition and Dietetics plant-based statement on plant-based diet. They're nutritionally adequate throughout all stages of the life cycle, including pregnancy, you know.
What is it called?
Academy of Nutrition statement on vegan diets. Veganism is not just a diet, but of course it includes a plant-based diet. But
absolutely, cool, but, super cool.
But also I would point you to websites called Challenge 22. Those people can help you out for free. Any questions you have, like, where do I get my protein now? Like, how do I get my B12? Those people, they give you a registered dietitian for free, and they can help you out if you want help. Because, you know, you can do it by yourself. I did it by myself. But if you want help, you can get
it. In the beginning, it may feel overwhelming. Absolutely.
It's called Challenge 22 because supposedly it takes 21 days to...
Well, Maui and Joey are a bonded pair, so you'd have to steal both of them. 777 quadrillion 777 trillion 777 billion 777 million 888,888.
Okay, I will steal both of them. They will both be my kitties now. Thanks for the donation, Ethan, though.
You get a habit started.
Hi.
And so if you do it for 22 days, then you're vegan. You're just going to be a habit, you know?
Interesting.
We'll share that documentary with you so you see the standard practices and it feels more visual to you. That, oh, shit, that's the sort of shit I'm paying for. I'm not going to pay for that anymore. So I'll recommend you that documentary. It's called Dominion. You can look it on YouTube. And then the website. I'll share with you. The
super
Chinese
awesome.
Thing. Yeah, but thank you.
Fuck. Well, I think you did a good job. Who knows if she'll go vegan? It sounds like she's fairly convinced, but a lot of these people just, you know, say fuck it and go back to eating meat, so who knows? The Predator donated $2. You keep claiming people are making fallacious arguments. Sometimes you name a fallacy, but you admit morality is personal, subjective. You never admit that what is considered a fallacy and consistent is also subjective. Well, no. inconsistencies are objective, so a logical problem is objectively verifiable. What isn't objectively verifiable is whether or not you value logical consistency or or logic. So you can say, I don't value logic, so I have an epistemic standard where I don't care about logic, but that doesn't mean logic itself is subjective. Logic itself is objective. Thanks for that, Nation Predator.
And this is a priority number one before we talk about Palestinian state or whatever name you want to give it. That when we have a savage group, Islamists, by the name of Allah, hijacking and using children as human shields, their own children, after killing Jewish children, then this is a capital crime. We cannot blind our eyes. We have to deal with priorities. First, we remove this savage group out of power. If Abiy's intention were pro-peace, then this is our intention that we should unify our efforts toward this main goal, first goal, priorities. Then after that, we can talk about the future and this criminal you call Marwan Barghouti in Israeli prison.
How are you supposed to differentiate who is and who is not Hamas when Israeli authorities have literally called almost every entity in Gazan society Hamas, including UNRWA? They even are calling students on college campuses Hamas. I mean, there's summary...
No, they're not doing that. That's just a lie.
Executions of doctors thrown in mass graves.
No evidence of that.
Because they're called Hamas. So I'm sorry that this label has been rendered completely meaningless. And as far as the term human shields, look, there's been no evidence, according to Amnesty International.
Are you still going to debate Amendum again, or did learning more about Ephelis turn you off of that? If I ever debate him again, I'm going to debate him on something like the Holocaust, because I found out later he's a Holocaust denier. So I'm not really interested in debating about Ephelism in general, but especially with a public figure like Amendum, there are so many more problematic things he says. He's a Holocaust denier. He supports the use of child pornography. In the context of, if it's already made, we should allow pedophiles to have access to it so that they don't rape children. Like, he has so many fucking problematic takes that I don't want to have a debate with him on Ephelism and promote his channel and shit and then funnel people towards that, like, brain rot bullcrap. I'd rather debate him on something a little more important, like the Holocaust, and then maybe from there I could debate him on Ephelism. But like, his definition of Ephelism is also fucking retarded. It's based on moral realism, and he hasn't actually made a logically coherent argument for Ephelism, so. It would just be another moral realism debate at the end of the debate at the end of the day too, because it's rooted in moral realism. How would you verify a logical argument? What is your theory of truth? Just look up. Just read on. What's it called? Just look up. Formal and informal logic and read up on it. Like again, if you're going to say nothing is true, it's all subjective. Like, you're going to have to say, like, the world didn't exist until you came into being. You know, you're going to have like a position like that.
Well, during CASLED and the 2014 onslaught and today, I mean, there is absolutely no evidence provided that Hamas uses human shields and that somehow justifies this heinous slaughter of predominantly women and children in Gaza. And even if they were literally standing behind hostages, you still can't just kill hundreds of people in a single airstrike because a Hamas commander is right there. And that's exactly what Israel is admittedly doing through AI. They're saying that they could kill up to 100 civilians for every Hamas official. It's absolutely
Yeah, because the single Hamas official is so dangerous that it justifies killing 100 civilians because they would likely cause more death. On top of that, again, many of the civilians in Gaza support Hamas. The majority do. So I don't know why you would be so concerned with civilians dying when it requires a certain amount of civilian casualties to take out one Hamas official.
Absolutely outlandish.
But if a group like Hamas launches a terrorist attack on Israel that kills 1,200 people, they take over 200 more people hostage, including babies and Holocaust survivors, that is a declaration of war, which they knew would lead to the kind of response we've seen from Israel. And Israel would argue, and they would have some sound argument to this, that if someone declares war on you in that manner and you respond, and in eliminating the terrorists who committed that heinous crime, civilian casualties are incurred, they would say that that is exactly what has happened in any other war in history, that the principle is the same, that the civilian loss of life is appalling, but that the principle of retaliating...
If she's going to say, no or very few civilian casualties are acceptable in war, then she's going to have to condemn every war. Like, even America's involvement in World War II would be morally unjustifiable. About 500,000 German civilians were killed during World War II. So she would have to say, oh yeah, America and the Allied forces should have never engaged in World War II and should have just cucked to Hitler because it caused hundreds of thousands of civilian casualties. Just fucking retarded.
Against a body of people who have committed one of the worst terror attacks in living memory, that is why they're doing it.
Piers, there's no symmetry between the two sides. It's complete asymmetrical mass slaughter of women and kids. You know that.
Well, actually,
and you could
Hamas
also make
did commit a mass slaughter
preempted.
Of women and kids. They did. You said there's no symmetry.
Piers,
there's an absolute symmetry.
But there's no symmetry. There's no symmetry between an occupying, colonizing force and the people that they're occupying.
I don't see why the fuck that matters. Most wars are asymmetrical. One military power is going to have more technology, more forces. Like, what the fuck does this have to do with anything?
And colonizing. You could obviously make the same argument that preempted October 7th, that it was a declaration of war to siege Gaza, to prevent aid from...
The only reason there was a siege of Gaza was because of terrorist attacks, you fucking dumb bitch.
Thanks for taking time to react. BTW Raffaella absolutely obliterated Sean Baker in that debate. I love how she went straight to Netette and maintained the conversation linear. She's amazing. Some vegans who have debated public figures should take pointers.
Yeah, she's a really good debater and made Sean Baker look like a fucking retard. He's still a salty bitch about everything, and he's still posting videos trying to clip things out of context to try to make Raffaella look stupid, but... Yeah, he's the one who looks like a fucking idiot. Like... He knows he lost the debate, and he knows he looks stupid. That's why he's being such a salty bitch. It's great. Thanks for the donation, Harry.
I'm getting in to shoot people that stray too far out, that are fishing, that can't go get medical aid and are sentenced to death within Gaza. Is that not a declaration of war? Is it not a declaration of war to violate international law to maintain a brutal fascist military dictatorship in the West Bank? These are all... these all preempted October 7th. So it just keeps going back and back to what is the root of actual violence, Piers.
Okay, Mossab, I'll give the last word to you. Where do we get peace from all this hell?
Listen, naturally, if the Israeli protocol is not sufficient and it's not satisfactory to the expectations of Abby and many of her friends. Then I say, how about we punish Hamas by their own laws, by the Islamic law? Why don't we follow the Islamic protocol? In this case, the Islamic law says, behead all men and take all women and children as booty. This is their moral stand. So she say it's asymmetric. Well, we already know that. It's a very dirty war. We are dealing with people with the mentality of the 7th century tribalism. It's not an easy mission for a democracy, for any country, for any modern army, for any civilized society to deal with this. So we need to be reasonable. I understand if people are anti-war and they are pro-children, pro-life, me too. But sometimes we have to make very difficult choices. And Israel was really pushed to the corner. Israel is fighting for its very existence. I am fighting for my very existence. I did not kill any Arab. I did not kill any of their tribesmen. But they want me to cease to exist. Why? Because I criticize their religion. I criticize their stupid ideas that are leading towards global chaos. And instead of spreading the narrative, the victim narrative, what we need to do actually, we need to localize it, not globalize it. And we need to be reasonable of our expectations from a democracy in the middle of crisis.
Okay. Mossad Hussein Youssef, Abby Martin, it was a spirited debate. I think I learned, as I always do from these debates, I learned a little bit more than I knew before. So I thank you both very much indeed.
The chief prosecutor of the International Criminal Court is seeking arrest warrants for some top Israeli and Hamas leaders. The proposed warrants are in connection with their actions in the war since the October 7th attacks. Among those named in the ICC request are Hamas leader Yahya Sinwar and Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu. The ICC chief prosecutor, Karim Khan, told CNN that his office requested the warrants based on evidence that suggests those named are responsible for war crimes and crimes against humanity.
Of course, hostages have not been released. That insidious crime, it continues for so many innocent Israelis that are in custody, you know, held hostage by Hamas, and families that are waiting for their return. And of course, we see pictures of starving children, of emaciated children. We have a variety of evidence to support, not polemics, but evidence that's been forensically analyzed to sustain the charge also of starvation being used by Netanyahu and Gallant as a method of war, and it's awful.
Meanwhile, Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu told MSNBC that the International Criminal Court request draws a false equivalency between Israel and Hamas.
It's a rogue prosecutor who's out to demonize the one and only Jewish state. And he's doing that by first applying a false symmetry. He's equating Israel's democratically elected leaders with the terrorist tyrants of Hamas. That's like saying, well, I'm issuing arrest warrants for after 9/11. I'm issuing arrest warrants for George Bush, but also for Osama bin Laden. And in World War II, I'm issuing arrest warrants for FDR, but also for Hitler.
Israel and the United States are not members of the ICC and do not recognize its jurisdiction. However, most countries, 124 of them, including Canada, are parties to the court's treaty. This means if the court issues arrest warrants, any country that is a member of the ICC would have to arrest them and extradite them to The Hague.
Obviously, the International Criminal Court is independent in its work, and I've said from the very beginning how important it is that everyone respect and abide by international law. What I will say is troubling, though, is the sense of an equivalency between...
There is a huge problem when you have international courts and you can have one single fucking prosecutor bring up charges to anybody in a member country. Like, it doesn't really make any sense because, like, one single individual who can prosecute anybody from any country, like, the risk of political bias is just so incredibly fucking high.
In the democratically elected leaders of Israel and the bloodthirsty terrorists that lead up Hamas.
For more on this, we're joined by Ido Moed. He is Israel's ambassador to Canada. Ambassador, welcome back to the show.
Thank you for having me.
You heard there the Prime Minister. We heard it from the Foreign Minister, the Deputy Prime Minister, that Canada rejected the equivalency between Israel and Hamas that your government says is implied in these charges. But they did not condemn this move by the ICC.
I don't know if I'd ever have the courage to allow this to happen and not do anything about this being done to me.
That is a nasty, disgusting hornet. Ugh. Man, I hate those goddamn things. Why the fuck is he doing that? I have no idea why he let a hornet that size sting him. I remember right after I broke my elbow mountain biking, I was working on my motorcycle. I think I was like I can't remember if I was changing the oil or changing a tire or something. And this fucking wasp out of nowhere, when I'm minding my own business, fucking stings me in the elbow that I just fucking broke. Like, they're just assholes. They just fuck with you for no goddamn reason. I fucking hate hornets. Thanks for the donation, finger my ass.
You see the way people like U.S. President Joe Biden have done. What do you make of Canada's response to this?
I think that Canada has made the right decision to condemn the fact that there is this outrageous moral equivalency between a democratically elected government and a hyenas terrorist organization. Hamas has set out to kill Israelis, as many as possible, to destroy Israel. We know Hamas's agenda, and the international community must act against Hamas. On the other hand, you have an Israeli government, a democratically elected government, a very robust legal system that works and has shown time and again that not only are we working against anybody who breaks law within Israel, but in real time, under combat, we are able to use, to apply international law as no other military has been able to do in the world until now. So in our actions, we have shown that we are applying international law, and this this sort of libel that the prosecutor, the ICC prosecutor, is trying to present against Israel is outrageous, because it actually shows that the international law, the international system, order-based system, is actually crumbling. If that is the case, if you equate a terrorist organization with the government, when we have full evidence to show that there is no starvation, that I think that you remember from the first time that you and I spoke about how Israel applies international law, that we are doing our utmost to make sure that the civilians are staying out of harm's way in any way, shape, or form. That is, that's military harm, that's food, that's water, that's anything that can be provided for their security and safety.
Okay, there's a few things to go through there, but I want to start with the moral equivalency argument. Is it moral equivalency to hold people on opposite sides of a conflict accountable for their own individual actions, you know, in the abstract way? I mean, if in fact, if you read the indictment or read the request for the warrants from Karim Khan.
And pro-Palestinians will still deny that they aren't Nazis and admire Hitler even after the IDF found this lol fucking insane and delusional copes.
Discovered today by IDF troops during operation activity near Wadi Fuchin in the West Bank. Yep. Yeah, it's all about trying to destroy the Jews. The Arab Authority at the time in Palestine, he was actually really close friends with Hitler, and he was helping him recruit for the SS. So there's a long history of Nazism and Nazi sympathy, you know, with the Arabs. So yeah, that's who that's Hamas, that's the Palestinian people. And then people try to say, oh, poor Palestinians, oh, Hamas isn't that bad. They're literally Nazis. Thanks for the donation, finger my ass.
On the prosecutor, he makes the point that there is starvation happening in Gaza, that they've been denied food, they've been denied water, and he points to comments made by Mr. Gallant, the defense minister, who said he referred to Palestinians as human animals, saying we are fighting human animals and we will act accordingly. Is it moral equivalency to hold people accountable for their own actions?
So if you take a murderer and the victim, and you say, and the victim hits the murderer back, and the murderer is not able to kill the victim, would you hold both of them the same balance and you'll say, well, why did you hit your murderer? This is outrageous. This is using the same language that South Africa has been using in ICJ, to a sort of a blood libel against Israel, to blame us for being able, for protecting ourselves, for fighting back against Hamas terrorist organization that uses humans as the population as human shields. We've shown that time and again that this is what they're doing. We have shown how we are operating on intelligence and very meticulously and very slowly so that we can retrieve our hostages, which, by the way, the prosecutor says they are held in custody by the Palestinians. I mean, just the choice of words showed it that this person has an agenda against Israel.
Well, what would his agenda be? I mean, we've seen Karim Khan. He's gone after Putin for what's happened in Ukraine. Why do you assume there's an anti-Israeli agenda?
Ask him, why didn't he go after Maduro in Venezuela? Just a question. He met with him. Just ask him that. I mean, this gentleman has some kind of an agenda which is against Israel. It's to pin this blind libel against us because he doesn't like Israel. He doesn't like Israel to exist. I don't know. I don't know what his agenda, but it's clearly he has an agenda, and that's evident. He's not been to Israel. He's not verified. Whatever he's stating, he has not been able to establish by himself. He's claiming he has proof. Israel has delivered 20,000 truckloads into Gaza, which amounts to 2 million tons of food supplies into the Gaza Strip. Israel has repaired the water pipes into the Gaza, to the northern part of the Gaza Strip. Long time ago, Israel is making sure that the Palestinian population is kept out of harm's way all the time and gets the food supplies that it needs all the time.
The allegation, though, in the documents filed by the ICC is that starvation is being used as a method of war, that including the denial of humanitarian relief supplies. And that's a big part of why he is seeking the warrants against your prime minister and your defense minister. So I know you say supplies are getting in and you say there is no famine there, but they say they have documented evidence, videos, and witnesses of starvation happening inside Gaza as a result of Israeli policies.
So he can use that wherever he wants. It's false. As we speak today, an hour ago, Israeli Defense Forces just released information about 650 tons of supplies, humanitarian supplies, sitting on the Palestinian side, waiting to be delivered to the Palestinians. That's an issue that's beyond Israel's control. This has been going on for a long time. We've been supplying food into the Gaza Strip. We've created more openings through the air, through the sea, and by land, through Ashdod port, from Jordan. So we have we've gone to enormous lengths to make sure that the Palestinian population stays out of harm's way. And why would we do that? Because we believe that at the end of the day, these...
Oh my God. I'm very fucking tired, and I don't know if I can keep streaming. I am very, very tired. And for some reason, there's only like 100 people in the stream. I don't know why people weren't getting notified. But, I don't have any shrooms on me to take, dude, even if I wanted to. So, I think what I'm gonna do is try to get to bed and, get some sleep. Tomorrow, I will probably do a stream in the morning where,
I'd drag my nuts through broken glass for the opportunity to sniff the militant vegan's ass. Thanks for showing her channel.
Well, glad you enjoy her channel. And, you can sub to her OnlyFans. She does have an OnlyFans. So, if you want to see her butt, lots of nice butt pics on her OnlyFans. Thanks for the donation, vegan cum. But, tomorrow, I'm probably going to do a stream in the morning. I have to do a bunch of maintenance on my motorcycles. I have to change the rear tire. change the battery, and I have to swap the rear brake pads on my V-Strom. So I'll probably stream that. So we'll have like a bike maintenance stream. Then I'll do another stream at night, you know, the usual thing. But since I'm tired and since...
Do you think it's accurate to call Islam, which is false, some form of an Arab supremacist ideology?
Kind of. So, it kind of is. Muslims have, like, Muslims claim that Muslims don't racially discriminate. They only discriminate against religions. But if you actually look at Islamic history, they've enslaved people, particularly of certain ethnic groups, not just non-Muslim Arabs. So they've particularly enslaved black people and Jews. So, it is, like, again, if you at least look at the history of Islam, yeah, it does racially discriminate, and it does seem like, you could say it's like a form of Arab supremacy. Thanks for the donation, Goomba. Dodo Donate Tellers, how you understand why China has the number one most terrible disputes with the most countries? They have no manners.
Chinese tourists pig out at Thailand buffet were caught on camera while behaving badly. The tourists were filmed amid a feeding frenzy at a hotel buffet in Thailand. Seafood seems to be their food of choice as one by one they frantically climb over food onto another.
Yeah, they do this because there's a long history of starvation in China, so anytime they're offered anything free, they go ballistic.
And Chinese tourists throw hissy fit in Hong Kong hotel.
Don't touch me! Back off! Making a big fuss won't help anything!
Gonna hell on Sunday.
Around, do you expect us to
people for just a single night, according to authorities. The expired credit card they had used to book the $1,000 expense, however, was declined. Apparently knowing full well they didn't have a proper reservation ahead of their departure, the group nonetheless decided to air their grief with hotels.
Yeah, that's what they do.
You idiots!
Chinese tourist taking selfie falls into Grand Canyon. A Chinese tourist planned to take a selfie by the rim of the Grand Canyon fell through. Well, in this case, moreover. According to David Leibowitz, a spokesman for Grand Canyon West, a 12-person tour group from Hong Kong was skywalk a 50-year-old man from Macau accidentally plunged 1,000 feet over the edge. AZ Central reports that according to Leibowitz, a...
Well, that's not too smart. But, I'm gonna go nighty-night now and get some sleep, and tomorrow we'll probably do the two streams, the, motorcycle maintenance stream and then the normal stream at night. But sweet dreams, everybody. Big thanks to everybody who donated on Streamlabs. Really appreciate it. Nighty night.